Hey guys, once again, this is Mason from AR500 Armor, and today we're coming at you with a brand new product that we've got coming out, and I just wanted to go over it pretty briefly with you guys and give you an introduction to it, all right? So let's jump right in. If you take a look here, we got our new AR500 Armor Battle Belts, and we're gonna take the time right now to kind of go over what it is and how the system works to give you guys an idea of where you wanna start from when you're getting into battle belts, okay? So first, let's jump right into this. Battle belt is a three-part system, okay? There's an inner belt, which is this. Then there's a duty belt, and finally, there is an outer sleeve, all right, that you notice the molly webbing on it, okay? So the way this works, your inner belt is gonna go through your normal belt loops on your pants, right? Nothing complicated about that. This duty belt section here actually slides into the sleeve, right? So you just run it through. And then you can put all your pouches and stuff, like on this belt, on the outside. You can also run a holster down through it, and also any of your just traditional like military issued holsters with a Velcro strap that goes up in there. You can run all those on the belt itself, and it gives you the real estate to run all kinds of different pouches and stuff on it. So let's kind of go into how you would actually put this battle belt together real quick, just so you guys know what you're looking at. And then we can talk a little bit briefly about how it's gonna be configured when you guys purchase it, okay? So in order to set the battle belt up properly, as I mentioned, this inner belt right here, which will be sized to you. So there's like a small, medium, large, and extra large. Pretty simple to operate, guys. You just slide it through the buckle. You wanna make sure that the loop Velcro material is facing outwards, and it's gonna fold in like that. Now the purpose of that is, if you look on the outer sleeve and the duty belt, you will see there's actually hook Velcro, right? And what that does is, when this is through your belt loops on your pants, you hook the duty belt or the outer sleeve to the inner belt like that, and it keeps the belt from moving up and down on you, right? Which is kind of an issue that some people have with like the padded belts that just go over clothing, is that when you take a knee real fast or you go prone and then get back up again, it can actually move up or down and get kind of uncomfortable, or worst case scenario, kind of fall off of you. Well, there is a time and a place for belts like that. The system that we designed was designed to be on you at all times, right? It's something that isn't gonna fall off, it's not gonna slip or move around. So we wanted to use this Velcro. Now the system is intended that you can use it with the inner belt as like an EDC belt. It's a pretty sturdy belt. We did a lot of testing in-house where we had guys use as their carry belts for a little while, and all positive feedback came back on that. It's a pretty simple belt, nothing too crazy. Or you can run it in conjunction with the duty belt if you're in more of a law enforcement or security field. You can just thread your normal like handcuff pouches, mace pouches, you know, pepper spray, any of that stuff. You have to run handcuff cases on here. And you can wear it just kind of set up like this as a duty belt. Now it's important to note, guys, that for that use, we actually designed this with what is called a cop lock buckle. So let me take this off here and I'll show you guys how that works. Once you apply the buckle, it looks like a normal side release buckle. You clip it in just like that, right? Nothing too crazy about that. But if you notice here, there's actually a little button right there. That is the actual cop lock. If I try and open this like a normal slide release buckle, you'll see it doesn't come undone. This is basically a safety that just kind of prevents anybody from randomly coming up and undoing your belt, or just from it getting undone in the course of your normal duties. So you have to push in on that, and then you can slide it apart. Right, this is a pretty important feature to us. We wanted it to be nice and sturdy and durable. So of course, use ITW Nexus buckles on these. All American made buckles, good stuff. Just to make sure that you don't have to worry about it shattering or breaking on you, or like I said earlier, kind of anybody just, you know, ripping it off from you. So then if you want to run it in its primary configuration, which is going to be with the tactical sleeve on the outside, what you're going to do, unclip the cop lock buckle, undo the belt. You will notice on the outer sleeve that it kind of curves upward at the edges. Now that's just kind of a little feature, but what it does is that when the belt's actually wrapped around you, it kind of prevents it from bunching up quite as much as it would if we just made a flat belt. It kind of curves to your body a little bit. So you'll take your sleeve, take your duty belt, it will run through the belt. There's a little piece of loop Velcro on the inside of this edge of the battle belt. The purpose of that is just to prevent the belt from sliding up and down when you take it off, right? Because you want your stuff to stay in place. So just put your finger in there and that kind of blocks it. I usually like to have a couple inches space between the edge of the duty belt and the buckle itself, just like that. Now you take your next section, slide it through. There you go. You'll see there's a little gap right here. That's done intentionally. It's one way that we use to increase the size of the belts. It just kind of increases this gap a little bit. But also, this is where you can attach some of your non-standard dump pouches, or conversely, our AR500 Armor dump pouch, which has a sleeve that you can slide onto a normal belt, or space to actually molly it onto the carrier using that PALS webbing. So that's kind of up to you. I like to just run my dump pouch on the belt directly. But that's, again, just personal preference. All right, so then you slide it through the last section, and then if you're right-handed or correct-handed, as I like to say, this is where you will actually attach your holster to the belt, right? So as you slide this part through, you're gonna put your holster up in there and then slide it through the loops on the holster, and then it will hang down the side if you're running, or down the bottom if you run a Safariland holster or whatever other, just a strap, you can just slide it in there and Velcro it, too easy. Now you take your buckle. Back through, oops, just like that. And of course, because we use the hook and loop Velcro, it will adhere to itself. Awesome. Now, again, covering that internal loop Velcro slot with your finger, you can slide the belt up, push it down, and looks like we bunched up a little bit. Same thing on this side. Cool. And now what you'll notice is there's these little things here. That's perfectly normal, because when you actually close the belt and it's on your body, it just gives them a little bit of space to move around, okay? All right, and then that's kind of how you set the battle belt up itself. Now, of course, you would put whatever pouches you want to run on it. We're gonna have another video coming out pretty soon here that's gonna kind of just go over the kind of stuff we recommend putting on a battle belt. But again, it's not a definitive thing. It's kind of up to your individual needs and what you intend on using the belt for, all right? But we think that you'll be happy with this three-part system. Again, you can use the other parts in conjunction with each other. It's a pretty inexpensive option compared to some of the other companies out there. It gives you enough real estate to put the pouches that you need on it. Now, I mentioned at the beginning, we'd go over sizing. So the belt will be offered in different sizes because, of course, you know, we're humans, so we all vary a little bit. The inner belts are offered in small, medium, large, and extra large. The duty belt section is offered in a small, medium, and a large, extra large configuration. Because it's so adjustable, right, that just kind of saves a little bit of space on everything. So the outer sleeve, of course, itself will then be offered in, again, four sizes like the inner belt, right? There's a small, medium, large, and extra large. The only difference between the outer belt sleeves in sizing, like I said, there's gonna be a little bit bigger gap here. Because of that gap, on the large and extra large belts, there's actually an additional two columns of molly webbing that extend out there. That just gives you a little bit more real estate. If you have a little bit of a larger frame, you just have a little extra room to put pouches. You know, not much of a big deal. Otherwise, guys, that about sums it up. Now, also, just be aware and be on the lookout. We do have an armor option coming out for these things a little bit down the road, okay? So if that's something that you're really looking forward to, don't worry, we already thought of that, okay? There's gonna be a soft armor option that you can add onto these belts. And you're not gonna have to worry about any kind of revisions to the belt for that. It's already been designed to be compatible with this belt system. All right, so there's no need to worry about that stuff. That'll be coming out a little bit later down the road. So just keep an eye out for that. I'm sure we'll do a big release about it. Otherwise, guys, that's about all I have for setup of the battle belt. As always, if you guys have any questions, comments, or concerns about this stuff, feel free to drop us a comment down below. You can also head over to our website and get in touch with our customer support people at the email address that we have. Feel free to send us a Facebook direct message or leave a comment on some of our posts on Facebook, and we'll do what we can to help you out. As always, guys, thanks for tuning in. If you like this kind of content, be sure to follow us, like our YouTube, subscribe to our Facebook channel, stuff like that. We also have an Instagram. We do a lot of giveaways and stuff, so that might be a good idea. Otherwise, guys, you stay safe out there, and take care.